Well, good evening. I'd like to welcome you to our service this evening, and we are having a blue Christmas service here this evening. And I want to explain to you a little bit about blue Christmas. It's also called the longest night in the Western Christian tradition, and it's a day in the Advent season marking the longest night of the year. On this day, some churches in Western Christianity held a service that honors people that have lost loved ones and that are experiencing grief. So this service is for those who are at odds with the season, that feel estranged from the general feelings of joy and happiness that's typically associated with this time of year. Some of us here tonight may have suffered lost ones, and I can say that myself. Death of a loved one, divorce, illness, or the loss of a job. And tonight's service seeks to comfort all that are mourning and reminding us that we're not alone and that our feelings are honored. So welcome this evening, where we're going to provide space to mourn over the losses. And truly, this has been a year full of loss, and we've all experienced it through the pandemic and being isolated from one another. But this is our time to mourn together. I'd like to open with a gathering prayer, if you would pray with me. Your compassion for us overflows, O God. We are facing our longest night. We come burdened with sorrow, loneliness, and sadness. We come seeking a place to set them down, a place where our words will be heard and our feelings honored. We need a place where we can drop our masks of good cheer so that our tears can flow. We need a place where we can freely wear the face that we really are. So be among us, God, tonight. Let your compassion heal us in this moment. Strengthen us. Care for us. Be Christ for us. Amen. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Reading from the book of Isaiah 40:1, 25 through 31. Comfort, oh comfort my people, says your God. To whom then will you compare me? Or who is my equal, says the Holy One? Lift up your eyes and see. Who created these? God, who brings out their host and numbers them, calling them by name. Because God is great in strength, mighty in power, not one missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from God, and my right is disregarded by my God? Have you not known? Have you not heard? Our God is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. Our God does not faint or grow weary. God's understanding is unsearchable. God gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even the youths will faint and be weary. And the youth will fall exhausted. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. If I were in church, like in my church back home, everybody would have said by now, amen. So I'm going to say it, amen. I will lift up my eyes to the hills. From where is my help to come? My help comes from God, the maker of heaven and earth. God will not let your foot be moved. God, who watches over you all, will not fall asleep. Behold, God watches over Israel and shall never slumber nor sleep. God watches over you. God is your shade at your right hand, so that the sun shall not strike you by day nor the moon by night. You know this? God shall preserve you from all evil. It is God who will keep you safe. People shall watch, and God will watch over you. You're going out and you're coming in from this time and forevermore. Glory to God, Christ the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, until the end, forever and ever and ever. Amen. Matthew 11, 28 through 30, just to encourage you. Come to me, all ye that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and I will give you rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light.
Of hell thy people save, and give them victory o'er the grave. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel.
Liturgy of Remembrance, lighting of four Advent candles. We light this first Advent candle in remembrance of all those we have loved and lost. Let us take a moment to say their names, to remember their voices, their stories, their faces, their bodies, their spaces in our lives. Let us remember the memories that connect them to us during this season of expectancy. We remember them. We hold them in love. We present them to God. We thank God for their lives and our lives. We remember them with love. We acknowledge the loss. We name them and grieve the loss. May God, eternal love, surround them. Now we will have a moment of silence and reflection to remember all those who have died. I also invite you to say their names aloud or in silence. And I'll light the candle. We light this second candle to remember the pain of loss, loss of relationships, loss of trust, loss of jobs, loss of health, loss of joy, all the losses we have suffered this season and in the past. We embrace the pain of the past, the pain that makes this Christmas season hard. We present all our pain, our losses, our abundance, and our hearts to you, O loving God, requesting that unto your suffering love and compassion, you will give us the gift of your presence, the calm, the peace in our hearts. We remember that in you, O God, all things are possible. Redeem the pain of the loss, refresh us, renew us, and lead us into hope and your future. In silence and in reflection, I invite all of you to name the areas of renewal aloud or in your hearts as I light this second candle.
The
This is our third Advent candle. We light this third Advent candle for those experiencing the loss of direction in their lives, and to remember those struggling to embrace their changing path. We have blamed ourselves, others, and even God. We pray to God to direct our path. God, as you directed Moses and your people through the wilderness to a new land, help us. Help us to find direction in our wilderness of today, God. Guide us. Restore a sense of direction and purpose in our lives. Show us where we are now and where we need to be headed. Lead us, O God, and give us wisdom. Illuminate our path with your brightest light. God, hear our prayers. God, our death, we cry out to you to be our guide. Take all this, all that we have lost, God. We bring it home to you. We remember that though the winter be upon us, and though the night be dim and long, the dawn will come with the brightest of the day. And now in silence and in reflection, I invite you all to name and give to God all that is lost as I light this third Advent candle.
Oh, come, thou dear spring, come.
This is our fourth Advent candle. We light this fourth Advent candle as a symbol of hope, the hope that the Christmas story offers us. The light of this candle reminds us of the faith, the hope, and the life God offers us. God of comfort, you are our light, and you are our strength. Enable us to accept your love and peace. We remember the relational God who comes to share this life is faithful. We remember God who suffers with us and light our way, and also reawakens our hope and joy. We remember the God who shares our burdens, who shows us the way to the light, and who journeys with us into all our tomorrows. And now in silence and reflection, I invite you to bring your burdens to God and take God's light and hope this for the Advent candle brings to us. As I light this candle.
Remember the one who shares our burdens, who shows us the way to the light, and who journeys with us into all our tomorrows. Brothers and sisters, it has been an especially difficult year. As we gratefully receive God's grace, I encourage you to extend that grace to our neighbors, to all those around you. Offer words of peace and acts of kindness when you can. The world needs it right now. But I also want to encourage you to allow yourself grace. Listen, we're in the middle of a pandemic. This is hard. Whatever you're doing is enough. You are enough. Be kind to yourself and hold on to hope. If you need help, if you're struggling, please reach out. Contact us at the church, Pastor Nancy, Pastor Jeff. You can reach out to me. I'm in the directory. You're not alone. You can also visit the cdc.gov website and search for grief and loss in the search box. And there are many resources there that you might find helpful. You're not alone. Keep holding on to hope. We're going to get through this by the grace of God. Now I would like to share a reading with you. It's a poem written by Jan Richardson that was comforting to me, as I hope it will be for you. It's about God's work within us, even as we grieve, even as we feel at times like the world is ending. It's called Blessing When the World is Ending. Look, the world is always ending somewhere. Somewhere the sun has come crashing down. Somewhere it has gone completely dark. Somewhere it has ended with the gun, with the knife, the fist. Somewhere it has ended with the slammed door, the shattered hope. Somewhere it has ended with the utter quiet that follows the news from the phone, the television, the hospital room. Somewhere it has ended with a tenderness that will break your heart. But listen. This blessing means to be anything but morose. It has not come to cause despair. It is simply here because there is nothing a blessing is better suited for than an ending. Nothing that cries out more for a blessing than when a world is falling apart. This blessing will not fix you. It will not mend you, will not give you false comfort. It will not talk to you about one door opening and another door closing. It will simply sit itself beside you among the shards and gently turn your face toward the direction from which the light will come, gathering itself about you as the world begins again. Now is the time in the service when I would like to invite you forward to light a candle, to honor a loss that you are experiencing or have experienced this year or before and hold it before God. But because we can't do that in person, I invite you to light these candles in spirit as I do so physically for you. Maybe you'd also like to have a candle at home that you can light. If that's meaningful for you, you can do that as well. But as I light these candles, think of a loss that you are struggling with today. Maybe it's the loss of a loved one. Maybe it's a job or health, a sense of safety or trust or purpose. Maybe it's a lack of normalcy related to our physical and social distancing. Whatever it is, I invite you to lift that up to God today as we light the candles together. What I'll do now is I'll light a candle, and after a few seconds of silence that I'll give you to lay that down before God, I will say, God of all comfort, and I invite you to respond with, grant us your peace. God of all comfort, grant us your peace. We bring our grief and our loss before God. God of all comfort, grant us your peace. 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 Please join me in prayer. Generous and gracious God, we gratefully wrap ourselves in your compassion as we thank you for your presence this night. Overwhelmed by our burdens, we easily forget that you never leave us alone, and your steadfast love for us never falters. In you and in our brothers and sisters, we find assurance and comfort that we do not suffer this longest night alone. You have given us strength to live through this night. Turn us to reach out to those whose night is also long. Grant that we may be your healing presence in their lives by bringing them your compassion and comfort. Amen. As we come to the end of our time together, I want to leave you with a blessing. These words were written by the same author that I read from earlier, and Jan Richardson. And I invite you to receive this blessing now, called Blessing in the Chaos. To all that is chaotic in you, Let there come silence. Let there be a calming of the clamoring, a stilling of the voices that have laid their claim on you, that have made their home in you, that go with you even to the holy places, but will not let you rest, will not let you hear your life with wholeness or feel the grace that fashioned you. Let what distracts you cease. Let what divides you cease. Let there come an end to what diminishes and demeans, and let depart all that keeps you in its cage. Let there be an opening into the quiet that lies beneath the chaos, where you find the peace you did not think possible, and see what shimmers within the storm. May God surround you this Christmas season in light, love, and peace that passes all understanding. Amen. God of all comforts, grant us your peace. God of all comforts, grant us your peace.